Hello guys and welcome back to LeetLogix. This is the amount of time for binary tree to be infected problem from LeetCode. This is a LeetCode medium and the number for this is 2385. So in the given problem, we are having a root of a binary tree and an integer start. So at minute 0, there is an infection which starts with the node value start. So we are given with a root of a binary tree and a binary tree we have. And also we have an integer start. And this start integer is having an infection at the minute 0, and this infection will spread all over the tree. And how it will spread? At each minute the node become infected if the current node is uninfected and the node is adjacent to an infected node. So suppose 3 was infected at minute 0, and so at minute 1 all the uninfected adjacent nodes will become infected, like 1 was uninfected, 10 and 6 was also uninfected, and they were adjacent to an infected node 3. So the next minute, that is on minute 1, the 1, 10 and 6 will also become infected. Similarly, at minute 2, 5 will become infected. At minute 3, 4 will become infected. And minute, this was 1, 2, 3. And at minute 4, 9 and 2 will be infected due to this fourth node. So this is how we are going to solve the problem. But there is a catch. We were talking about binary tree, but this is spreading in it is spreading in three fronts, the infection. So this is possible case. So how we are going to do? So in this problem, we are going to use both a BFS and a DFS. The BFS will be used to convert the binary tree into a graph. So we'll be converting it into a graph. And the graph construction will be using BFS, and we'll consider it as an undirected graph where edge exists between the parent and the child nodes, and the main parent will be the infected node 3. Now, after once we have created the graph, what we can do is that we can perform BFS, and the level wise spread will be there of the infection over the trees, and which naturally aligns with the logic that the question asks for. So let's see through an example. Suppose we have this example 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5 with the infection node starting at 3. So first of all, the first step is the graph representation. So we'll try to form the graph. So for the node one is connected to 2 and 3, so the graph becomes for 1, 2, and 3. 2 is only connected to 1, so it becomes 1. 3 is connected to 1 also, 4 and 5 also, so 1, 4, 5. And 4 is connected to only 3, and 5 is also connected to only 3. So in this way, we have created a graph, and we can now apply a BFS traversal on this graph. So first of all, we take a visited array, because in BFS traversal, we need a queue and a visited array, so that we don't encounter a node twice. So then we'll initialize a visited array in a queue, and then we'll start the BFS algorithm and simply apply from the starting infection, that is the start node. With the help of graph, we can traverse the array, and at the time when all the nodes are infected, we can simply return the level till which level we have reached. That minutes of time is needed for the binary tree to get infected. So let's come to the code section, but before that, do like the video, share it with a friend, and subscribe to the channel. So first of all, we would need a map. So I'll define a map here. So here we have the adjacency list, and this will be a new array list. Oh, sorry, we are taking a map now, so this will be a hash map. So okay, we have the hash map. Now we'll call upon the helper function convert to graph to convert this binary tree into a graph, and let's define the queue as well for the BFS traversal because we would need that afterwards. And we'll also need a visited array or a set, so we can define a visited set. So visited equal to new hash set. Here we have defined all the necessary data structures. Now we need to add queue.offer, the start node, and then we can simply perform the BFS traversal. As you know, the BFS starts till the queue is not empty. So till it is not empty, what we have to do, we'll do a time plus plus. Let's also define a time. So this is actually the level. So we'll define it minus one because in the first iteration it will become zero. Then we have I equal to zero. Then it will be q dot size we'll take a node one by one, add its left and the right. Q dot pole first, we are taking it from the front. You can take it from the back as well, but I'm taking it from the front of the queue. Visited dot add the current node dot value. Actually we can add the current node itself because it is an int, so we'll add the current node itself. Because in the queue we have added the only the values. Now we have to check if adjacency list dot contains key current node. So if it has the children, then what we can do, when then we'll add all the children into the queue. So we have to add all the neighbors of the adjacency list with the current value. Current node we have to add it. We'll add it in the visited and also in the queue. No, we do not need to add it in the visited, we will simply add it in the queue. So see, this is the entire BFS. First of all, we define all the data structure that is needed for the BFS traversal, that is the queue and the visited array. First of all, we add the starting index, that is the start where the infection starts. And then we have a time, this represents the level till which level we have reached while spreading the BFS. And then we are what we are doing is that we are taking all the entire nodes in the queue at a particular level, and then we are adding its children into the queue as well by checking if they are not in the visited array. So this was the BFS part. Now let's move to the graph creation part. But before we return here, we need to return the time. Now we need to define the convert to graph. First of all, we'll check if the node is equal to null. Then we can simply return. Otherwise, if node dot left not equal to null, then we can add in the adjacency list. We can do a compute if absent. So if it will be absent, we can create this. So node.val and a new array list will be formed. Then in that we can add the node.left.var. And similar thing we have to do for the parent also, because since we are creating a graph and not a tree, so we have to put the relation both ways. So left dot val, and this will become node dot val. So let's remove the left from here. And we need to write similarly for the right as well. We'll do copy simply from here. I can copy this. This will become right. This will also become right. And then we can call convert to graph node dot left node dot right. So this is our solution. Let's try to submit it for the sample test cases. Some error. Let's see what the error is. It is in the DQ. So this will be line number 35. It is current node and cannot find visited. Why it does not find the visited? Was so you can see we have passed the sample test cases. Let's run for the unit test cases as well. I know there was a little bit errors, but I am coding it in front of you. I do not have a saved code, that's why there are some errors. So I hope you understood the logic. You can also check my solutions by going into the solutions panel, and this is my solution. You can see the intuition, the approach, the Java code, the C++, Python and JavaScript code. Let's talk about the time complexity. So the time complexity of the solution is O of n, where n is the number of nodes in the tree, and the space complexity is also O of n because we are using queue visited. So that's why. So I hope you understood the logic of this question, and you can solve this question in an interview very easily. Do like the video, share it with friends, subscribe to the channel if you are new to the channel. Thank you for watching the video. Have a nice day.